Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in this video we will start a new chapter, that is rotational motion. So first let us discuss about the introduction of rotational motion, then we will proceed further. So let us start with rotational motion. Hello students, let us start a new chapter, that is rotational motion. So I will give you just a brief idea. About rotational motion. Basically, the motion is when one object changes its position relative to the observer, then relative to that observer, the object is said to be in motion. For example, if two persons are sitting in a car or train and the train is moving, then with respect to one, the other one is at rest, so they are not changing position. So the one person who is sitting next to the other person will say that he is at rest, but the person outside, when sees the both of them and obviously the train, they are moving and they are said to be in motion. So motions and rest are relative terms, and as far as this rotational motion is concerned, the rotational motion is when the object is supposed to be moving about a particular point, fixed point or axis, then they are said to be in rotational motion. So this is all about your introduction part. So now let us start with the chapter, and we'll first take one concept, and that is called moment of inertia. So this chapter, rotational motion, to understand this chapter, we have to first understand what is moment of inertia. Without this, this chapter cannot be understood. So first let us start with moment of inertia. Moment of inertia is basically the is a quantity which measures the degree of with which the degree of easiness how easily an object can rotate about a given axis. Might be about its own axis or might be any other axis which is lying out in the body. So that quantity which determines the degree of rotation, in fact how easily you can rotate a body, that is moment of inertia. This is the physical meaning of moment of inertia. That means if I say that if the moment of inertia is more, then it will be difficult to rotate the object. Similarly, if I compare it with the translational motion, when a body is moving in a straight line, then we can say that if a mass is heavier, if the mass is too much, then it is difficult to translate the body. So whatever moment of inertia plays the role in rotational motion, the same role mass plays in translational motion. More mass implies more difficult it is to translate the object. More moment of inertia implies more difficult it is to rotate the object about a given axis or any specific axis. Now, so far so good. We have to analyze it in terms of formulae. What is the formula? That means how to measure moment of inertia, how to calculate moment of inertia. To calculate moment of inertia, we have to have a definition of that and a formula. So let us start with that. Then we'll have a relationship between the physical significance part of the moment of inertia. So first let us start with the definition part of moment of inertia. So it is defined as the product of mass of the particle. Basically, this formula is valid. Direct formula is valid for point mass. So mass of the particle and the square of its perpendicular distance from the given axis of rotation. That means what it says that if I have an axis over here, this is called the axis of rotation, and I consider a particle here. Particle is supposed to be point mass, having mass m, and it is at a perpendicular distance. That means from this axis I cannot say take this distance, because this distance is not the perpendicular distance, or any other distance I cannot take. I have to take the perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance means the shortest distance from the axis of rotation, and that should be this one, and this is 90 degree. When you take the perpendicular distance, suppose that distance is r from this axis of rotation, the body, the particle will rotate about this axis like that. Then moment of inertia, the symbol I'm using is I capital, and the moment of inertia is defined as mass of the product of the mass of the particle and square of the distance, that is mr square. This is the formula you to use for moment of inertia. Now if I talk about the unit of this, then it is kilogram for mass and meter square for distance square. So it is kilogram meter square, and the dimension is this is the mass and this is the length. So ml to the power 2, this power is 1 and t power is 0. So it doesn't depend on the time. So this is basically not a vector quantity. So basically moment of inertia is not a vector. It is you can say it is a scalar quantity. That means you can have all scalar operations for moment of inertia, but it's better to say moment of inertia is a tensor quantity. It is a tensor one, okay. And for the same object, as you change the axis of rotation, the value of I will change. So therefore it is a tensor quantity. Anyway, now this is valid. You have to remember that this is valid for point mass. If the mass is not a point mass, it is something else, then we have to devise a method, or we have to take the help of calculus. So we'll take the help of calculus to define or to find the moment of inertia of a given object about a given axis. So this is all about your moment of inertia, the definition. And now in the next I will just discuss about the comparison, that is physical significance of moment of inertia. So let us start with the physical significance. Of moment of inertia. The physical significance of moment of inertia. It is asked for 2 marks. So it is asked for 2 marks, and you have to write 2 points only. One is that more the mass implies more difficult it is to translate the object. This mass is called translational inertia. This mass is therefore called this is the inability of the body to change its own state on its own. That means it cannot change its state by itself. That property is called inertia. So whatever the state, it maintains that state, it tries to maintain the state, it cannot change on its own. More difficult it is to translate the object if mass is more. If I compare this translational motion with the rotational motion that is under consideration, then I will say that more the moment of inertia, implies more difficult it is to rotate the object. This moment of inertia is also known as rotational inertia. Okay, this is called as rotational inertia. Okay, now I have also to explain. So it is clear from here that if I take heavier mass, you will find it difficult to push it or to move it. If I take a lighter object, it can be easily displaced. More moment of inertia means more rotational inertia. Wherever the inertia to rotation is more, that is, moment of inertia is more, obviously the rotation will become difficult. And for the same object, the difference is that this is constant, for a given mass, that is, translational inertia is constant for a given mass, but rotational inertia is different, that is, moment of inertia will be different for a given object, because that depends on the axis of rotation, whichever axis you choose for a given object. For example, if I take a disc, the moment of inertia about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its plane is half mr square, where m is the mass of the disc and r is its radius. But if I take an axis which is passing through the center but lying on its own plane, then about the diameter, then it will be 1/4 of mr square, that is 1/4 times mr square. So that part is easier to rotate. That will calculate later on the how I get this value. But to rotate an object, if I take a, help you understand that, if I take a ring, and I rotate it, about it in diameter, it will rotate easily and it will rotate for a longer time. Then I try to rotate, I take the ring and rotate it like this about vertical axis passing through its center perpendicular plane, it will hardly make any rotations, 2, 3, 4. But about diameter, if I keep the ring like this and rotate it, for example this one, supposing I'll just give you an example. Suppose this is a disk, then this axis is the perpendicular axis passing through the center, and perpendicular to this plane. About this axis is difficult to rotate, it is half mr square, but about this axis diameter, it is still more half of that. So it is easier to rotate about this axis, just like how I'll rotate the object about this axis, I'll rotate like that. You can see on your own, you can see here, you can see here, or you can see here, no problem. You can see that you can try on your own. This rotation is more time or very easy. You can see here. You can try at home. I don't have that. See how many rotations. But if I rotate about this axis, you can see here, hardly one or two. One, two. But here, it will be easily rotated. You can see here. If you take a proper ring and then rotate on your own, you see that that is so for a given object, if I change the axis of rotation, this axis or this axis, or I can have about this axis also, the lesser the moment of inertia you get, the more easier it is to rotate about that given axis. So this is one part of physical significance of that. So this is the physical significance of moment of inertia. It is different, and I'm not writing, you can write. This is different for a given object, but it's same for the same object. Okay, so this is all about your rotational motion, moment of inertia, and physical significance of moment of inertia. Next video, we'll discuss about few other things. Thank you.